Welcome to lecture 17th of electric power system. The topic that we are going to take is short transmission line. So any transmission line whose length is less than 80 kilometers is considered as short transmission line. So transmission line having length less than 80 kilometers is considered as short transmission line. Short transmission line, generally we neglect the line capacitance because the current is very small, that is the leakage current. So here we will be neglecting the line capacitance. The third point is all the parameters will be in the lump form, that is the resistance and inductance are in the lump form. Generally in long transmission line we deal with the regress parameters or the distributed parameters. Here we go with lumped parameters. Now the equivalent circuit of a short transmission line. So the equivalent circuit of a short transmission line consists of a resistance and a reactance which is in series, known as the series impedance of the transmission line. Here we have the sending end voltage and at the load side we have the receiving end voltage. The current that is being released by the source is known as the sending end current, and the current that is being taken by the load is known as the receiving end current. So here we do not have any capacitance with this line. So the capacitance is neglected and the parameters R and X are lumped in the transmission line, So if you write the KVL and the equation, here in this particular loop and the KCL equation, so we get that the source current is equal to the receiving current, that is the sending end current is equal to the receiving current, the sending end voltage is equal to receiving end voltage plus the loss associated with the line, that is IR into Z. So what is the total amount of loss in the transmission line? It is equal to the current, either sending end or the receiving end current, I write IR, and the Z, that is the impedance of the transmission line, where the Z is equal to R plus JX. So these equations are used for determining any short transmission line. So the three equations will be used to define any short transmission line. Now let us see the phasor diagram. So in the phasor diagram, we can take the receiving end current as the reference phasor. Then the receiving end voltage VR will lead the receiving end current IR by an angle of phi R. That is the receiving end power factor. So phi R angle is basically the angle between the receiving end current and the receiving end voltage, which defines the receiving end power factor as cos of phi r. Cos phi r is the receiving end power factor. Then we have the equation as the sending end voltage is equal to the receiving end voltage plus the IR into the drop Z, which can be written as R plus J time X. So if we draw the phasor diagram of this particular equation, we get it in this form. Okay, so we have VR cos phi R, that is a drop of VR in here in the F, and then we have the drop IR and the drop IX. So the total impedance is IZ and VS is the total source voltage or the sending end voltage. Then if we draw the triangle and then we write the hypotenuse theorem or the Pythagoras theorem, we get an equation OD square is equal to OG square plus GD square. So we'll get the hypotenuse OD is the hypotenuse is equal to OG square, that is your base OG square, plus the perpendicular, that is your GD square. Right, this OG can be broke up into OF plus FG, and the GD can be broke up as GC plus CD. So if we substitute the values of OF, FG, GC and CD and OD, we are basically getting an equations of sending and voltage as under root VR cos phi R plus IR square. This is the real part of the equation and this is the imaginary part. So this is your real part square plus the imaginary part square. So we are getting the sending end voltage Vs as under root VR cos phi R plus IR, that is the drop along the resistance square, plus VR sin phi R plus IX square. So this is the sending end voltage. Now if we again obtain the power factor cos phi S, so cos phi S, that is the sending end power factor. So this is sending end power factor. Sending end power factor means the angle between the sending end voltage and the sending end current, the cos phi of that. So you get cos phi S as the base by hypotenuse. So you have the base as OG. So this is your base OG divided by the hypotenuse, that is your OD. So base by hypotenuse, if you divide it, then we get as cos phi S, which give you VR cos phi R plus IR divided by VS. So we can easily obtain the cos phi S value if we know the receiving end voltage, receiving end current and the parameter of the line VS and phi R. Now, if we take the VR to be the reference phasor, it means if we take VR to be the reference phasor, then angle will be 0, which is equal to the resistance plus J angle 0. Okay. Now, for lagging current, if the current is lagging, then the receiving end power factor angle phi R will be having a negative sign, which is a negative sign. So I cos phi R minus J time I sin phi R. If you have a leading power factor, then you can take a positive sign for your angle. So it will be I cos phi R plus J time I sin phi R. Now for a unity power factor condition, the angle will be 0. So it is equal to the current I plus J 0. Now the total impedance of the line, we have seen that Z is equal to R plus JX. It means the sending end voltage Vs is equal to VR plus I times the Z, because here the sending end current is equal to receiving end current, which is equal to your I, and the total drop in the line is IZ. So total drop in the line is I into Z. So the for lagging power factor, generally the power factor will be lagging in nature. So for lagging power factor, we know the equation Vs is equal to VR plus I times the Z, Z is equal to R plus J time X. So if we have this vector form of VR and VR taking to be a reference phasor, so we can get VR angle 0 plus the current I is negative, that is minus phi R, and here we have R plus JX. So if we break this in the trigonometric form, we get I cos phi R minus IJ sin phi R, and VR angle 0, we get VR plus J 0. If we split the equation, finally we get it in the, again in the form of sending end voltage as under root of VR plus IR cos phi R plus IX sin phi R square plus IX cos phi R minus IR sin phi R square. And the value of 10 delta is equal to this. So 10 delta is equal to, you can see the equation here, the delta is basically the angle of, this is your delta. So delta is basically the angle of Vs with respect to the current. So the angle of sending and voltage Vs with respect to the current, which is a current, is known as the load angle or power factor angle. So power factor angle 10 delta is equal to IX cos phi R minus IR sin phi R divided by the base, that is VR plus IR cos phi R plus IX sin phi R. So this equation is we are getting when we are able to deduce the trigonometric rules of the equations with respect to this. So this is your delta, here you have Vs and here you have the current. Now we are knowing these three equations that will be governing the short transmission line. the sending end current is equal to receiving end current, and this is the KVL equation for a particular loop, and this is the total impedance of the line. So this is the total impedance of the line. So if we have the known this total impedance of the line, then the sending end quantities, so all the sending end quantities, that is the sending end voltage and sending end current, can be written in terms of the receiving end quantities, in the term of receiving end quantities, with a parameter which is known as ABCD parameter. So here if we use this equation and write it in the matrix format, here we are getting the value of A to be 1, B to be Z, and C to be 0, and D to be 1. So this is the ABCD parameter of the short transmission line. Next topic that we are going to take is the voltage regulation of the line. So voltage regulation, how do we define? It is the rise in the receiving end voltage. So how much receiving end voltage is risen when in terms of the full load voltage, when full load at a specified power factor is removed, keeping Vs constant. So here we have seen that the sending end voltage is Vs is constant. So you keep the sending end voltage constant, and here you have the load at the receiving end. So load at the receiving end. So if we remove this load from the full load to the no load condition, full load to the no load condition, how much the receiving end voltage is affected, or there is a change, or there is a rise, is governed by the voltage regulation. So at full load condition, you will be seeing that VR is equal to VR full load, we write it, and at no load we write the, because when there is no load in the line, so this is your Vs. Now here you have the line with transmission constant Z, and there is no load. So if there is a no load, then there is no drop in the line, and your Vs and VR will be equal at the no load condition, because there is no drop in the line. Then in that case, the regulation of the line can be written in terms of formula: voltage of the receiving end at no load condition minus voltage of the receiving end at full load condition to the base of receiving end at full load condition into 100 for converting it into percentage. So generally this regulation will be greatest for lagging power factor and least or negative for the leading power factor. So generally the regulation will be more when your power factor is lagging in nature, and when it is negative or least in case of leading power factor. Then we need to determine what is the line efficiency of a short transmission line. So we have seen in the previous discussion also, lecture number 16, that the percentage efficiency we are calculating in terms of power output by power input. Now this power output is basically the power that is obtained in the load side. So the load power is power output, and power input can be written in terms of power output plus the losses in the line. So power output is the receiving end power, and here you have receiving power and total losses of the line. So the power output can be written as VR IR into cos of phi R. So if you know the receiving end voltage, receiving end current, and the power factor, we can easily calculate what is the power output of the line. Similarly, the losses that you have the line is basically your current which is flowing in the line divided multiplied with the impedance, and the losses in terms of power is basically I square into R. So I square R is the total amount of loss that is you have in the line. So voltage regulation and line efficiency are the characteristic and performance of the line. So that completes the short transmission line. And in the next lecture, we are going to take the medium transmission line. Thank you.